Here's a Coronado, which was the house brand for Gamble's department store way back a long time ago. This is a 5-tube AM radio from the late 50s, early 60s. I replaced all the capacitors and put a new speaker in it. Cabinet's in pretty good shape. It even has an input for a phonograph. Really, the only major damage to the cabinet is this metal trim piece that I need to glue back down. But here is the label on the underside of the radio. I don't know how well that's showing up on your screen, but there it is. Okay, I'll turn this on and let you have a listen. It has a pull-on volume knob. And of course, it'll have to warm up for a little bit since it's a vacuum tube unit. They don't come on instantly like the solid-state radios do. This is a really nice sounding radio. It's a shame we don't have any decent music stations in this town that'll really show it off. But my little SS Tran AM 3000 transmitter is on its way. That should be changing real soon.
When mama said you would never be nothing.
Big nail. Three old rusty spikes.
You said, bucket of water. And back to the house. Well,
and the American Dental Association to give kids a smile. Severe tooth decay.
This has an unusual volume control. In this position, of course, that's minimum volume. Turn it to the right to increase the volume. But to increase the phonograph volume, you turn it to where there's no sound, and then you go back the other way.
Glenn Beck Show on WALT News Talk 102.1 FM and 910 AM.
Tim LaHaye, author of the Left Behind series, recently told Glenn that he lost a lot of sleep reading Wrath and Righteousness by Chris Stewart.
Okay, enough of that. So there you go, the late 50s Coronado tube radio. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.